Lankford, Inhofe, Russell, these are name brands in Oklahoma politics. And another familiar face joins me now from Washington, D.C., Chris Casteel. How are you tonight, sir?
I'm doing well, Dave. Thanks.
Well, no surprises there in those three names, huh?
No, none at all. As soon as Lankford won the primary over T.W. Shannon back in June, he was headed to the U.S. Senate to replace Senator Tom Coburn, who was there for since 2004 and decided to resign with 2 years left on the term. Set off a bit of a domino effect in Oklahoma Republican politics this year, but you had Lankford running for Coburn's seat, leaving the U.S. House to do that. That obviously left Lankford's seat open. You had a pretty crowded Republican primary to fill Lankford's seat. Steve Russell, the retired Army officer, author, former state senator, came out of that primary, runoff primary against Corporation Commissioner Patrice Douglas. And once he came out of that runoff in August, late August, that one was pretty much over with, too. These are just Republican seats in a very red state right now, in what looks like to be a very Republican year in President Obama's 6 year in office.
We mentioned Republican Jim Inhofe. He is turning 80. He'll be one of the more senior senators now. He'll be 86 at the end of the term. You know,
That's
our
right.
Adam Kemp reported earlier, Chris, that Senator Inhofe entered tonight to the Rocky theme song.
You may remember, I think he had, what, quadruple bypass surgery last year, about a year ago. I think it was late October, sometime during the government shutdown, 2013. And just, the vigor that he came back with was really just kind of astounding. Last week, I talked to him on the phone, and he was in Jordan, going to the border of Syria, just to kind of see, just to check out the whole U.S., operation against ISIS. I mean, this is a guy who's like you said, he's 80 next month. And if he gets through 4 years of this 6 year term that he won tonight, he will be the longest serving U.S. senator in state history. There's two that have 24 years, Don Nichols and Elmer Thomas, and he'll pass him. He was actually sworn in early when he won for his first term in 1994. So if he just makes it to November of what would it be, 2018? He'll be the longest and the oldest ever too. So I don't, it's pretty amazing that he's got the young Lankford, 46 years old. I think he'll be 46 going into January's con. And it looks like, Dave, if all these projections hold, if Republicans pick up as many seats as the national projections have them picking up, that Lankford and Inhofe will be going into the next Congress in January as part of a Republican majority there.
Chatting, as you can see on the phone here, with Chris Casteel. He's in Washington, D.C. tonight. I'll just go over there and check on ISIS when I'm 79. It's impressive.
He really goes overseas quite a bit. He really, I mean, he's really just a road warrior. He goes to a lot of military bases, domestic military bases, goes to Africa a lot. We've written about that, and goes to Afghanistan, and used to go to Iraq, when we still had a more of a presence there. So last week he was in Jordan, he was in the Ukraine, and he was in Lithuania.
Well, after tonight, Chris, you'll get back to writing about politics as usual once we get past the election cycle here. And let's talk James Lankford, because his decision to run for state senate means Oklahoma City will have a freshman representing it, I believe, for the third time since 2007.
That's a good point. This is the third time. Mary Fallon was elected to represent that district, which is most of Oklahoma County, and then it's got Pottawatomie and Seminole counties in it. She was elected in 2006, 4 years later, left to run for governor. Lankford wins that, comes out of nowhere to win that seat in 2010. 4 years later, he's gone. So Oklahoma City, arguably the most, important district in Oklahoma. I'm sure Tulsa would give me some argument about that, but Oklahoma City has had a freshman congressman, this 3 times, as you said, since 2007. I think Steve Russell will hit the ground running. He's not some kid. He's a retired Army officer. He had some state legislative experience, but you still just have to learn your way around in this town. That's just all there. Yeah, everybody does, So we'll have a very young delegation in ways. We've got two freshmen now, Mark Wayne Mullen, Jim Bridenstine. So then we'll have Steve Russell. But we've also got two very experienced members in the House. Tom Cole of Moore, very influential.
And no surprise
Republican.
For him winning tonight either.
No, none at all. And Frank Lucas, who is the longest serving House member from Oklahoma. He's been in the House since 1994. He's chairman of the House Agriculture Committee, very, very seasoned veteran. So it's a good mix. It's, you know, good mix of the influential veterans and the up-and-coming young ones.
Fantastic coverage, as always, from our man in Washington, Chris Casteel. Chris, I'll let you get back to some politics, perhaps some Wizards basketball. I know you're a big fan.
Wizards and the Thunder.
Absolutely.
Love them both.
Chris, thanks for your time tonight. We appreciate it.
All right, Dave. Glad to do it. Take care.